PRP therapy, platelet-rich plasma, is it an appropriate treatment for osteoarthritis? What is it? How does it work? And most importantly, is it worth the money that it costs? So welcome to ShapeFixer. I am Andrew. I am a nutritionist. I'm an athlete. I suffered greatly from osteoarthritis. I have cured it with nutrition and rehab exercises. And one of the questions I get asked very often is about PRP therapy. So what is it basically? Platelet-rich plasma. Platelets are a type of cell found in your blood, and their function is to achieve clotting at the site of an injury to stop the bleeding, and they also stimulate the healing process. Plasma is just the liquid that your blood cells are in. So platelet-rich plasma is just your plasma, your blood fluid, with more platelets in it than usual and everything else taken out. This is then injected into the site of your injury, or in the case of osteoarthritis, into the damaged cartilage in the joint. And the theory is that it's going to promote the healing process. Now, in muscles and tendons and ligaments where there is a blood supply, although the blood supply in a tendon or a ligament is a lot less than it is in a muscle, but there is still a blood supply. And those tissues rely on blood in order to be able to heal. So it makes certainly sense that if you inject more platelets into that site, firstly, if it's still injured and there is internal bleeding, it will help to stop that. And secondly, there is some logic to the idea that it will stimulate the healing process and you will heal more quickly, which is very important, for example, for if you are very serious about your sport and you need to get back to training and competing quickly. Now, the issue around osteoarthritis is a lot less clear. There's no real science being done yet to show that it makes much difference there, because your cartilage has no blood supply. So your cartilage, to the extent that it does rebuild, and it does, it's just very, very slow. But it is not dependent on a blood supply. And so it's hard to understand why introducing platelets into the tissue is going to make any difference at all. In fact, the obvious question would be, do they not just get in the way and block everything up? Now, if your damaged cartilage is associated with damaged ligaments and tendons around the joint because you've had a really traumatic accident to the joint, then sure, the injection of the platelets could well help with the healing of the muscles and the tendon tissues, and certainly reduce some inflammation and feel better. But it's not a permanent solution. Very often, these injections need to be repeated. They can cost anything up to $2,500 per injection, with very little science around the efficacy of the procedure. So I would say for osteoarthritis and for cartilage that your best bet for regenerating is still proper nutrition to reduce inflammation, to provide the nutrients that your body needs to be able to build collagen and repair the cartilage, and the appropriate exercise to rebalance the muscles around the joint so that the underlying cause of your osteoarthritis, which is so often a muscle imbalance, is addressed and you are able to recover. And I would not be in a hurry to spend $2,000 or $2,500 for an injection that has very little science around it supporting the idea that it would work. And even sometimes without the science, the logic makes sense, and the logic here certainly doesn't. Injecting blood or blood components into tissue that has no blood supply anyway just doesn't quite sit with me in terms of the way I understand anatomy and physiology at the moment. So it could be a very expensive experiment. If money is completely no object, I suppose you could give it a try, because at least it is made from your own blood. So you're not going to have an allergic reaction or an immune reaction to it. It's not like introducing some untested chemical into your system. So that's my take on PRP therapy injections. Now, I did a video very recently on cortisone injections, which are very popular, have been for a very long time. And please give that one a watch too, to understand what cortisone really is. I can tell you that cortisone in an injection is not actually cortisone. But what it does and when it works and when it doesn't work and whether or not it would be appropriate for osteoarthritis. And it really depends what your plan is in terms of treating your osteoarthritis. So I think that's going to be an important and an interesting video for you to go and watch as well. So thanks for your time. Please share this video, click a like on it, and subscribe to our channel, because we make new content regularly.